Thank you. Holy Ghost, be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you.
To the people who return to Jerusalem after the exile, the prophet proclaims that God's salvation will fully come to pass. Jerusalem will become a shining light to the nations, and righteousness and praise will spring up as surely as the earth puts forth vegetation. The reading. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God. For he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness. As a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels, for as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not rest, until her vindication shines out like the dawn, and her salvation like a burning torch. The nations shall see your vindication, and all the kings your glory. And you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights.
Praise him, all you angels of his. Praise him, all his hosts.
Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars.
Praise him, heaven of heavens, and the waters above the heavens.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded, and they were created.
He made them stand fast forever and ever. He gave them all which shall not pass away.
Praise the Lord from the earth. You sea monsters and all deeps.
Fire and hail, snow and fall, tempestuous winds, tempestuous wind.
Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars.
Wild beasts and all cattle, creeping things and winged birds.
Kings of the earth and all the peoples, princes and all rulers of the world.
Young men and maidens, old and young together.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name only is exalted. His splendor is over earth and heaven.
He has raised up strength for his people, and praise for all his loyal servants, the children of Israel, a people who are near him. Hallelujah.
Second lesson is from the fourth chapter of Galatians, verses 4 through 7. Paul seeks to show the Galatians that the purpose of Christ's birth was to liberate us from the law's condemnation, so that we would be fully adopted into God's family as beloved children. The reading. When the fullness of time had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. Here ends the reading.
Righteous and devout. forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, then as a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped there with fasting and prayer night and day. At that moment, she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had finished everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their hometown of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Oh,
I'm telling you,
I should have came to your house.
Oh, my
the gift from God every day in our hearts. He gives us things like loving parents. You all have loving parents, don't you? That's right. He gives us our very life. Every day that we wake up is a gift from God. And every day we need to give him thanks for that gift. What if you sleep through the day? Well, when you wake up, because you do eventually wake up. When you wake up, you give him thanks, okay? And you're not even a teenager yet. So when you get to be a teenager, he's going to sleep all the time. You literally wake up at 6:30 every day. You're a good kid. I do not.
I don't even know.
Oh my goodness, you guys are really rising.
I don't even wake up right now.
You don't know. We are just going to get away today. Okay, back to what God gives us. Everything that is good in our life, everything is a gift of God. And we need to get pardoned. Do I? It is a long word because it is a lot of letters. But everything that is good and lovable and brings us joy, those are gifts from God. And sometimes we forget that, don't we? Sometimes, I bet, you forget that you have really loving parents. Huh? Sometimes maybe you might forget that because, you know, maybe they try to sway you to the way of the Lord, and maybe that's not the way you want to go. Right? Because we have a choice. But everything that is good comes from God, and we need to remember that Christmas is about the gift that God gave us in Jesus Christ. Can you hold your hands? Dear Jesus, we praise God, for the gift of you. Amen.
The way we stand today, We look back as well as we look forward, and we say the same presence of God will guide us into the future too. The key words for the congregation, as it has been for me and my family, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. God's mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness, O God. Lamentations 3:22-23. I would like this to become the memory verse for the congregation, to count how wonderfully God has led us all these days, and for the same eternal presence of God to be with us as we get into the new year 2024. The lessons that are given to us today in the lectionary, all those readings, I would like us to focus on that word, salvation. Is salvation a concept, an idea that we talk about, dream about? Or is salvation tangible? Is salvation something that we can see and recognize? We look at different characters in history, those not connected before actually meeting, but who are gathered at a particular space, place, time, and moment. Simeon, Anna, Joseph and Mary, Jesus, and all others unnamed who are also present in the temple. Simeon, a person who is of age, and you find that his experience and Zechariah's experience of having served God, having witnessed to God's love and grace in their own respective lives, Simeon is there at the temple at that time. You know, there is something called as God's time. Last week I reflected on that. And that word is present in today's second reading in Galatians chapter 4. In God's own time, the word that is there is in the fullness of time. Fullness of time. Kairos. In Kairos, when God's moment comes, God sent Jesus. And you find God's moment in gathering people at a particular place, and for them to reflect on history, memory, and experience, all these put together. We find Simeon, who is able to connect the dots. What are those dots for him in history, memory, and experience? For Simeon, as a man, as a righteous and a devout man, as a man of prayer, he has experienced God's ways, words of love and promise. To say you will not taste death until you get to see the Messiah for yourself. And for Simeon to believe in what he has heard, what he has been told, whispered in his mind and heart, for him to believe in that promise. You don't know when, whether it will happen at all, but you find Simeon recognizing that moment as the Kairos moment, recognizing in Jesus that promised Messiah. And the moment of that recognition salvation. You find he is filled with the Spirit, and he speaks words not just of wisdom, but also words of caution to Mary. You can imagine Mary's state of mind. She had questions galore when the angel appeared and when the angel said, "You are the favored one. And this is what will happen. You will bear a child." All those questions that Mary had, they didn't go away. They lingered in her heart. She kept meditating on those words. When the shepherds came to see that child, Jesus, they also share with Mary and Joseph their experience, their memory, their moment. They didn't go home straight, you know, after that vision, after listening to the angels and seeing that beautiful, beautiful sight. They were not overcome with that experience, go back home. Instead, they listen to the word of the angel. They go to Bethlehem to see the baby, to see Jesus, the child. And then the words that the shepherds share, Mary keeps those words in her heart, ponders over those words. What could this mean? What could I do? All those words would have been sown in her heart anew, and those words would have taken root within Mary. And you find Simeon's words, it is not just words of affirmation, words of encouragement, words of glory. Simeon also adds, a sword will pierce your own heart too. Just as much as Simeon's words would have filled Mary and Joseph with wonderment, this child will be the cause for the rise and fall of many. To that point, Mary must have wondered, what could be the future of this child? But the moment that last verse comes from Simeon to say, and a sword will pierce your own heart too, probably Mary and Joseph could have become a little more protective of their child, could have prevented the child from stepping out into danger, any danger, or just following him around like a shadow. You find Jesus' words when he is there in the temple at age 12, preaching, proclaiming to those people. And when Mary and Joseph said, "Why did you do this to our son? We were worried about you." You find the words of Simeon would have come as a true reminder even at the foot of the cross for Mary. A sword will pierce your own soul too. What about Anna? Anna and Simeon are not related. Anna is addressed, identified as a prophet. Imagine a time when women were not remembered by their names. Women were often in the margins. You find this person, Anna, who's remembered by name and who is named as a prophet. What a person she should have been at that time in her own context. For her not to have been dismissed into the crowds because she has surrounding her in the temple. So something that we have to note based on our reflections. In God's plan, in God's time, it is not blood that defines relationship. Jesus teaches that to the disciples and to the crowd, especially when somebody tells him, your mother and your brothers are waiting for you. He says, who is my mother? Who are my brothers and sisters? Those who obey the word and follow the word are my mother, brothers, sisters, siblings. The relationship is grounded in the word and in the promise of God. So when we address ourselves as siblings in Christ, we are affirming two things. One, we are intertwined. We are related. That's much more than just being connected, both to each other as well as to God. That is a non-negotiable given. We do not negotiate who can be our brother, our sister. God has gifted us this relationship, connecting us as a family in and through Jesus. What else but faith, hope, and love being the lens through which Simeon and Anna look at salvation? If you turn to your bulletins, you would find, once again, Simeon carrying Jesus in his arms. Simeon touching salvation, bearing salvation in his arms. Affirmation of Jesus as the center of salvation. Today, when you come up to receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, you are invited to come and bear that gift of salvation. Touch the body of Christ. Receive the body of Christ as new love, new life, and new peace. May the peace that passeth all understanding keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God. Amen.
Thank you.
and day, all creation praises you, O God. Strengthen your church across nations, denominations, and traditions. Fill us with wisdom and unify our proclamation of your forgiveness and mercy. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
All creation is holy to you, O God. You cause the earth to bring forth its shoots, and gardens to spring up. Protect hibernating animals and frozen lands that wait earnestly for longer days of awakening and growth. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
The nations are upheld by your hand, O God. Cause righteousness and praise to spring forth, inspiring leaders to serve with compassion and integrity. Send your spirit of discernment upon legislators, grappling with complex decisions for the sake of common good. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Send the spirit of your Son into our hearts, O God. Come quickly to hearts that race with fear, hearts that break with grief, and hearts that long for wholeness. Reveal your power to heal and to save. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Adopt us into your family, O God. Bless our elders with peace and joy of Simeon and Anna. Strengthen those who have retired, those who work in older age, and those in need of income, food, company, or health care. Connect young ones and old across generations. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Let us depart in peace, O God, according to your word. For all your saints, we give you thanks. Prepare our salvation in the sight of all your witnesses of every time and place. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of mercy, come quickly to us with grace upon grace as we lift these and all our prayers to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Merciful God, we offer with
joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our minds, and our possessions. Signs of your gracious love, we see them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophet's hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your son Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth. All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, Power of the Most High, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
In Christ's manger, at Christ's table, come see what God makes known for you. The body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Thank you. Jesus.